Bem, este período que reporta o chamado combate do Coa.
This period that turns back to the so-called Battle of Coa is chronologically situated roughly around 1810, and in a movement that in army terms is called the Third French Revolution, led by Macedo. This period comes immediately after the siege of Cidade Rodrigo. There's an approach to the Portuguese border and a preparation for the future siege of Almeida. Meanwhile, Wellington had prepared Almeida Square for resistance, but left Crawford's light division beyond the Coa. This division, with the support of the British Dragons Light Infantry, had the purpose of delaying the advances by the French army, and somehow tried to stop them from finding secure points. Crawford's orders were to retreat immediately, to cross the bridge into the other side of Coa. He doesn't follow that order, and decides to camp close to Almeida on a rainy night before the 24th of July, 1810. He was then surprised by a quick advance by the Loyson's Light Division. They're always the main divisions that advance on the field. They're a kind of advanced army that during the night, despite the storm, came all the way from Cidade Rodrigo to near Almeida and surprised Crawford around 6 a.m., dismounting his camp close to the fortress of Almeida. Crawford tried to retreat beyond the Coa, but it was already too late, and the French tried to stop him, and there was a battle throughout the whole slope from the so-called Calçada do Coa, the main street that went from Almeida to Guava, down to Coa's bridge. There were advances and retreats by the British Light Infantry, and by the Portuguese one as well, which had a few hunters there in an attempt to stop the French troops and keep them from going behind them and stop them from crossing the river. This leads to a high death rate, especially when the men try to cross the bridge, about 2,000 to 3,000 men descending and trying to get in amidst all the confusion, which is normal in a situation like this. The French take advantage of this, surrounding them and having a better chance to shoot the gathering of men, which leads to a high death rate. But Crawford had sent his few pieces of artillery on the other side of the river, in a peak called Quebeso Negro, and that artillery begins supporting the retreat of the few men that had been left behind. Most of them managed to cross the river. And then the French make a strategic mistake. Crawford had made this strategic error, and then the French make one as well. They try to cross the bridge when the Portuguese already had a steady defensive position on the other side of the river, with the artillery on a high point and with all the men along the slope in camouflage with firepower. The French try to pass, which also leads to chaos and even more victims. If we make a balance, there were even more French victims than Anglo-Portuguese. Let's put it this way, in this battle. In a generic way, this is what happens and what anticipates roughly what's going to happen later in the Almeida siege.